It's 2020, and you're listening to Good Taste Brekkie with Chloe Maxwell on Juice 107.3.
Ladies and gents, now it's time for In My Day with Beverly.
You make me feel so young.
Hello, sweeties. My letter today comes from Allison in Cedar Creek. And Allison writes, Dear Beverly, what are your opinions on the toilet paper crisis? Allison. Yes, finally something that I can relate to. An epidemic. Yes, in my day there were epidemics left, right and centre. And don't you feel that in life there is nothing like the fear of death to get people living? Or fighting over toilet paper in this case. Yes, the great toilet paper crisis of the 20s has begun. 2020, that is. People are literally protecting their own derrieres when it comes to the coronavirus. Desperation has set in indeed. But in my opinion, if you're not going to unroll your three-ply TP and turn it into three rolls of one ply, are you really panicking enough? I must admit, I do find the fact that people are having extended fisticuffs in the lavatory paper aisle a little bit absurd. But if you are intelligent, it's a great distraction from the aisles that actually would count in an epidemic, such as food. Yes, while duking it out for their dookie paper, I will be sneaking into aisle 3 and stocking up on canned corn, sardines, and of course my favourite, my Spam. Oh, I do love my Spam. Oh, Allison from Cedar Creek, the fact is that these people hoarding bucket loads of toilet paper are going to find themselves up Cedar Creek without a paddle. You can't eat toilet paper, I'm afraid, people. You see, in my day, we didn't even have toilet paper. My mother simply cut newspapers into little squares and it was left hanging from a nail in our outhouse. And it was great because it would give you something to read whilst doing your business, and if you missed any of the news, your derriere was stained with the classifieds for reading later on. Now, this is not the first time in history that there has been a war on toilet paper, believe it or not. Yes, in 1973, Johnny Carson, you might remember him, he was the host of the late-night American talk show called The Tonight Show. And he created widespread panic because during his opening monologue, he read a newspaper clipping about a potential of a toilet paper shortage. Now, of course, in those days, there were shortages of everything. And so anything made people panic. It appeared, actually, that a Republican congressman at the time, he put out a press release just warning the public about a possible and in no way imminent toilet paper shortage. But the media totally ran with this statement, as media sometimes do, darling, blowing it far out of proportion with the omission of the word maybe and the omission of the word potential, creating what I like to refer to as TP fever. 20 million nightly viewers watched Carson, and 20 million people created widespread panic. And it spread faster than coronavirus on a cruise ship, darling. Yes, for a few months, toilet paper continued to be a rare find, until, like most short-lived trends, the hype fizzled away. The fact is that panic stemmed from a blatant rumour and it was fed by the media. I mean, just remember, folks, don't always believe everything you read or hear. Now, I'm not saying that coronavirus isn't a threat, and I'm not saying that it is. What I am saying is that in my day, if we were faced with an epidemic, we'd be more worried about what we were going to eat and drink than how we were going to wipe. Now, my advice for not getting sick, well, wash your hands, darling. Don't panic, and certainly don't let anyone cough in your mouth. I hope this helped you, and until next time, sweeties, remember, times are tough, but they were much, much tougher in my day.
'Cause you make me feel so young. You make me feel so young. You make me feel so young.